It's definitely a satire about the human activity of selling what you love. But it's also a kind of elegy for a way of publishing that used to exist that has really disappeared. I'm a publisher myself. I work for a small company in New York that used to be an independent publisher and now belongs to a larger group. And this is what has happened to most independent publishers all through the Western world, really. But the character of those houses was determined by the personalities of the men. They were usually men who started these houses, and that gave them all special specialties and special attitudes. And some people loved them, some people detested them, but they were always reflective of the forceful temperaments of these individuals. And I wanted to recall that and have a kind of laugh at it, a kind of loving laugh at it. It began as a kind of roman à clé, in that the two main characters, Homer Stern and Sterling Wainwright, who are rivals, peers, and who really don't like each other, were very, very similar individuals. I happen to know the men that these characters are based on, and I was in the situation of the protagonist, Paul, who works for one and is friends with the other and is sort of caught in between these two father figures. And I haven't pretended that these two characters weren't based on real people. But we start with the real and then we move into the realm of comedy. They're real, the characters are real, but what happens in the book is made up. Let's just say that Paul Dukács is someone I recognize. I wouldn't say he's exactly me, but his situation is one that I know very well. And his passion for books is something that I share. Ida Perkins is really an invention. There's nothing roman à clé about Ida Perkins. In a way, she's the kind of star poet that we should have had but didn't have. She's a kind of counterfactual. She's my revenge on reality, because the premise of the story of Ida is that a poet can be a rock star, can be as big a star as any writer of fiction, any singer, any actress. And of course, this isn't quite true in our world, but part of the fun of the book is imagining a world where that could be the case or could have been the case. So in some ways, Ida represents, a friend of mine after reading the book said, well, Ida is the spirit of literature. In a way, she is a kind of avatar of what all these men are looking for in a poet. So I've written poetry all my life, and this is really my first foray into fiction. But I wanted to use to make poetry the subject of my novel in a certain way, to have the protagonist be a great poet, to have her poems be part of the story. The plot turns on the poems. The poems reveal things about the story that are important to understanding, to the joke of the book. And it's a kind of jeu d'esprit about literature, that it's also a kind of Bildungsroman, where Paul grows up in the course of the book. His idealization of this Ida Perkins is quite naive in many ways, and he learns that. And he's basically turns from being a kind of delayed adolescent into someone with a more mature understanding of literature and society. But he doesn't lose his faith in literature itself. That's something that the people who make the books and who sell them and all turn out to be less perfect than he imagined them, but the actual thing that they're involved with remains an ideal for him in the book. I think that the fact that we're sitting here today talking about this book shows that literature is still something that people are interested in, concerned about. Look at your bookstore. It's an incredibly wonderful and successful institution. And the reason that is because it fulfills a meaningful role in people's lives. So I don't think literature has lost its relevance. It's an essential human activity. It's one of our highest achievements as human beings, actually. Its role in culture has changed, but it itself has not. The way young people will relate to literature will be different from my generation, your generation, because people change, situations change. That's part of the point of the book, is in the old days, it was a much more personal, artisanal activity. Now it's more industrial, but the actual books, the books that are on the shelves in your bookstore, the books that people buy in ebooks are literary works, and people will find their ways to relate to them. We don't read the way the Romans read. We don't. Books are a much more available and popular commodity than they were in the Renaissance. You know, in some ways, it's a better situation. The internet digitization means that all books are available to everyone now. That's a fantastic thing. That's better. So it's not just that things are different. That doesn't necessarily mean they're worse. Let's just say it's a complicated experience because I've been an editor all my life. I love working with writers, and I'm very used to the process, how it works. Sometimes it doesn't work. Sometimes it's a great success. Most of the times it's somewhere in the middle. But when it's your book, of course, your investment is different. I remember an agent friend of mine used to say to me, "Well, you as an editor have many books, but the author only has one. And when it's your baby, you can't help but be more concerned about it." But it was published a year ago in the U.S., and I've been watching it being published in various other countries, and you're able to have a slightly more objective view of how it runs in other places because you're not quite as responsible in a way. But I've been watching the French publication, finding it really great. It's really been more fun than having it published in America because it's a little bit more at a distance. I love my editor, Robin Desser at Alfred Knopf, which is another very good publishing house in America. She made me rewrite the book 4 times. She was very, very exigeant and terrific, and we were very close. And she made me make the book more realistic in certain ways, less satirical, so that the tension between realism and satire was more complicated. And I think that was a very smart thing. So it was a real education to be edited that way. And it was all good for me, I think, but not always comfortable.